अंदर ह्यूज अमाउंट ऑफ फैंस हम आ गए हैं नमिता दुबे के घर पे और उनका बर्थडे है सो हैप्पी बर्थडे फर्स्ट
थैंक यू गाइस एंड थैंक यू वेट दिस वाज एंड माय सिस्टर एंड माय ब्रदर इज
Thank you.
This is thank you guys for getting me the cake. This is for all you guys for doing this for me and for sending across this really amazing.
Thank you. So, birthday ka kya kya plan is? मेरे बर्थडे के ये प्लान्स है कि फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल माय सिस्टर सरप्राइज मी एंड माय ब्रदर इन लॉ दे सरप्राइज मी दिस सैटरडे दिस वीकेंड विच इज़ वन ऑफ द बेस्ट सरप्राइजेज आई हैव गॉट बिकॉज आई वाज नॉट एक्सपेक्टिंग कि मेरे बर्थडे पे पहले मैं सोच रही थी आई हेड ऑफ टू लोनावला और सम प्लेस एंड बी अलोन बाय माय सेल्फ विद अ फ्रेंड और टू बट नाउ माय प्लान्स हैव चेंज्ड एंटायरली नाउ आई थिंक आई एम सेलिब्रेटिंग इट विद एवरीवन हूएवर इज देयर इन बॉम्बे and I'll maybe do a get together or something and be with people who are actually very close to me, my friends and my family. So I'm very happy with that. My parents are not here, but it's okay. My sister and all these guys are here, so they have made up for that absence. Best surprise ever. There are a couple of cute surprises which I got. Like once this friend sent me a gift that was back in 2011 that I got this gift in Bombay. And that was the first time somebody had couriered a gift to me with a dress and an FC UK clutch and I was so overwhelmed that somebody has been sending a gift for me, so that thought was really nice and special. And other than that, 2 years back also, that was my first project that I was doing and I thought nobody would know that it's my birthday, but crew ke sare log mere hotel room mein aa gaye the and they sprayed me with this what do you call that foam,
yeah.
The party foam jo hota hai, snow whatever. So they sprayed me with that at 12 in the midnight and I had a call time at 4:30 in the morning. But I was still enjoying myself, so that was a very sweet gesture and they got me cake. And that's when I thought nobody remembered my birthday because I thought I'll be spending my birthday with strangers. But yeah, that was a very good surprise.
Anything that has happened to you, like, you know, that you feel like, oh wow, this is it, I just want it, and that you want to plan for your birthday next?
I have never given a proper birthday party in my life. I don't know how. बचपन में जो parties घर पर mom dad arrange करते थे वो अलग parties हुई थी, but after I moved to college I have not celebrated my birthday like कि you know take them out for clubbing or dining. It's always been very very like once I was at my sister's wedding, once I was at my cousin's wedding, once I was at my friend's wedding.
वेडिंग सीजन
सारी बर्थडेज में मैं किसी ना किसी की शादी में थी तो अपने आप ऑटोमेटिकली पीपल वी लाइक दे फॉरगेट दैट वी हैव टू सेलिब्रेट इट अगेन बट ऐसी कोई बर्थडे पार्टी नहीं करी एक्सेप्ट इन 3-4 years बैक व्हेन आई डिड अ बिग थिंग विद माय कॉलेज पीपल बट आई थिंक मुझे बर्थडे का इतना वो भी नहीं रहता है कि बहुत ज़्यादा कुछ करना है स्पेशल तो आई वुड आइडियली वॉन्ट इज टू ट्रैवल समवेयर मे बी डू इट एट अ न्यू प्लेस बर्थडे at like travel like I've been in different places on my birthday 2013 mein main Kolkata mein thi apni behan ki shaadi mein jin logon se aap bhi mile the camera ke piche un logon se milke un logon ki shaadi mein main Kolkata mein thi but other than that I want to travel and celebrate my birthday somewhere like a totally new place unexplored.
So we have a gifts from fans hamare paas bahut sare gifts hai.
Okay, all right. So this is a gift from Maria. And why am I not surprised, Maria? I was totally expecting this, but you've been so sweet to me and Priyansh and the whole team of Bade Bhaiya Ki Dulhaniya that it's just I don't know what to say. You know that I'm not good with words and I'm very awkward with gifts, but this is very sweet of you. So should I open this?
Yeah, obviously.
The gift box that has come out of the
so sweet. Okay, my God. So this is a message from Maria, and she's written, I don't have to read certain sections in this letter, but she's wished me happy birthday, Miss Awesomeness, Miss Supercool, Miss Dubey. May your coming year surprise you with the happiness of smiles, the feeling of love and so on. I hope you will find plenty of sweet memories to cherish forever. You're a person who always deserves the best and obviously nothing less. That's also, I've just gone all out to make your birthday extra special. Thank you so much. And all your tweets I've been reading, because every time I log into my Twitter or Instagram, I see each one of you doing that extra bit to make me feel special, and it really is very sweet. I can't even put it in words right now. Okay. So, they actually wanted me, this is a disclaimer, they wanted me and Priyansh to celebrate our birthdays together, but Priyansh and me have really unfriendly calendars. He's in Europe, he was in Europe, he's just come back to India, I guess. And I was in Bombay and Delhi, and we just couldn't meet, so we couldn't do it together. But hopefully we would do some segment together. I hope that happens. So she says that we wanted you guys to celebrate your birthdays together, but I couldn't let your actual birthday just fly away. So I made something exclusively for you. So happy birthday again. And there are some questions which she has written, which we'll do. Let's see what she's got us.
God.
Oh, open when you get this for your birthday? Open. Wow, they are actually handmade little notes. Open when you're feeling stressed. Now I'll open this and I'm actually stressed, you know. Open when you need a laugh. Wow, this is so thoughtful. Open when you need to know how much I love you. Nobody has done ever. No boyfriend has ever done this for me ever, Maria. Open when you're sick.
Oh God.
Okay, so open when you get this. So I will open this. These are specially meant for special occasions. And there are more cards in there. Okay. Open when you want to know more about me. This I'll do personally. I do want to get to know more about you. Open when you're having a bad day. Open when you need motivation. My God, I need to open this all at one go. Read when you're homesick. Oh, I'm already homesick. And open when you're sad. Maria, this is, I don't know what this is inside. I have no idea, but you know, I'll do this because I read everything that you guys wrote to me last time also. I read each and every word of what you guys wrote, and I was smiling like a maniac by myself while reading that all alone in my room. So this is very sweet. Handmade stuff, they just show how much a person cares for you and how much effort they've put into, you know, making you feel that extra special. Oh, and she's, this is so sweet.
Yeah,
it's an accessory. This is very sweet, yeah, Maria. Thank you so much. Thank you. So I'll open the one thing actually. When you get this for your birthday, so I want to see what is there inside and show everyone. Oh God. How sweet! Oh my God, this is the birthday I was just talking about where I got sprayed by the foam. There's actually a picture and a proof of that now. Okay. And she sent me a beautiful postcard kind of a thing with a girl with balloons. And my God. I'm feeling like on top of the world right now. This is so personal. Okay, so she's wished me happy birthday, and she's written how much I love you, girl. Okay, so this might be the first letter you're getting to read since your birthday. Oh, this is, I think, a personal letter, so I shouldn't read it. Yeah, this is a very personal letter that she's written to me. And she's written, hope your efforts pay off, birthday of yours becomes the most memorable one. And stay the same. And I love you. I love you too, Maria. Thank you. And okay, she's given me a personal message of what should be less, what should I do less, and what should be done more of. So less is talking, planning, and more is listening, doing, and more tea, more salads. That's so sweet. More love, more gratitude. That's a very, very sweet and thoughtful thing, Maria. You've actually made my birthday a notch higher special. Like it's I'm sounding very over, I don't know. It is very sweet. These are handmade things, and they just show the kind of efforts you've put into, the thought that you've put in behind every word, everything that you've written, typed, and the thought behind everything. I actually appreciate it very much. This is one of the most special gifts I've ever got. So thank you, Maria. Thank you so much. Chalo, our next gift is here again from Maria. My God, Maria, I think we should definitely meet. And like, we should have celebrated. Ah, this is so sweet. This will go down. I have kept everything that every gift and every everything that was sent across to us during the show. It's in my special drawer in my almirah. And I'm going to keep this there. I think I'll keep it in my room where my books are stacked. So thank you, Maria. And you've written someone special. Ah, you're special for me.
There is.
Yeah, Maria, I don't like so many gifts. Okay. So the message for this special. So the message for this is, hello, I think I just found your miniature, which is this gift. Probably as cute as you. I don't know there's anything in the world stuffed with as much love as teddies. It should always remind you that you're special. Today's your birthday. Enjoy it fully. Sending you loads of love through this tiny thing. And that's Maria. And wouldn't mind a 1000-volt smile on your face as a return gift. Yay! Maria, you've not made me smile. You've made me blush. You've made me melt. You've made me feel like, I don't know, that you love me so much that I have no words to express my gratitude towards you. Yeah, thank you so much.
Thank you. And sir, please don't send us cash. We don't accept.
Guys, please don't send money. Please. Yeah. I don't want. You can write to me. You can post pictures to me. I'll read and I make it a point to read everything that's posted about me, at least on Twitter. So I read all your messages and I try to reply to all of them. So please don't send cash.
And here for the cash we have Ferrero Rocher.
Thank
her.
You. Maria, these are my favorite chocolates.
Yeah.
Maria told you to buy. Maria, yeah, what you make see, like, I don't know what to say, what to do with you. Meet me. This is very sweet. I love Ferrero Rocher. Like it's one of my favorite chocolates. And some guy in my 11th standard had gifted me a big box. That was the first time I ever tasted that. I remember because I hadn't had yeah. So it reminds you of good things. Thank you. Thank you guys. Thank
so
you.
So we have some questions from Maria.
So Maria, you sent me very interesting questions last time also, and that got me into a lot of trouble because me and Priyanshu were answering, I don't know what trash we answered, because that all went like I don't know what. So let's see what questions do you have for me now. I will answer with a lot of sense and sanity now. I'll try. Okay, first question is, what have you been up to since BBKD ended? Are you still in touch with the cast? So as soon as I ended with BBKD, I was down with dengue. I got sick, and that was on 4th of October. We finished on 30th, and 4th I came to know that I'm terribly sick and I need to be home. And I had a travel plan, and that included someone, you know, that included Priyansh also. That travel plan got canned. And then I was resting home, and I went to Delhi to meet my sister, my brother-in-law, my friends, cousins. I visited my home in Firozabad, Agra, and I was meeting everyone and anyone who I could not have met in the past 5-6 months because of how busy I was. And yeah, and then in November first week I came back to Bombay, and I've been working on myself. Are you still in touch with the cast? So I'm in touch with Priyansh, and I'm in touch with Ritu, who used to play Madhu Chachi, if you remember. I met her when I came back to Bombay. So I'm in touch with mostly. Yeah, we have a separate. Yeah. No, okay. That will be too much information. Yes, I am in touch with them. When are you coming back on screen? What kind of role are you looking out for? That's a very tricky question. So when you're coming on screen, so now I know that you invest a lot of time in a character, in a show, in a serial, if you talk about that. But I want to open myself to all kind of opportunities that are there. It doesn't have to be a TV show only. So let's see what I come back on screen or wherever, on whichever platform. And I want, if it's a bigger project, if it's a lengthier project, then I want to be very wise in choosing that, because it takes a lot of your time, your energy, everything you invest in that. So that has to be something that I choose very wisely, and it has to come through organically. What kind of role you're looking out for? There's no particular thing, but anything that interests me, anything. It can be anything. Let's see if it's something different from what I've done before, but depends on the story. What are the 5 words that best describe you? 5 words. Impatient. Now I'm becoming patient now. Impatient. Book lover. Then short tempered. My sister's looking at me. I have some good qualities also. Then I'm, I think, very humble. But humble people don't say they're humble. So I don't. No, I'm immodest and pompous. And I don't know. Yeah, I can't. I'm also very impulsive sometimes. I feel very impulsive. Like, I take big decisions, and with small decision I keep fretting about. Big decisions I take like in one. So I can be impulsive also. So I think that those are the 5 words. What are your 3 biggest character flaws? I think I just said I'm not very patient. So I'm very impatient when it comes to things like cooking. And like, I don't know, I just don't have sometimes any patience to, you know, wait. I hate waiting. I don't like unpunctual people. People who are not punctual, I don't like people who make me wait. So, and I get very fidgety then. And another flaw that I have is I sometimes become very, I crib a lot about things which I should not be cribbing about. I should be more grateful about things which I have, but then I focus on things which I don't have, which I'm working on. So I'm hoping that flaw will not be there any longer. What are the 5 things you want more of right now? Could be anything. So I want, what 5 things I want more of? I want more clothes. I want more jewelry, accessories. I want more bags. Okay, these are the material things, but I want more patience in me, and I want more of what do I call that? I want a greater sense of art appreciation. I don't know if that makes sense, but I want to be, I want to read good books, be around people who are in who are doers, you know, who are positive about their craft. I just want more of this happening in my life. So that encompasses everything. They're not 5 things, they're a lot of things. What would you rather lose all your memories or never be able to make a new one? This is a trick question. I can't lose all my memories, but if I have to look forward to something, you know, sometimes you feel that the best things that have happened into your life are already behind you. That can be a big, you know, hurdle. So you should always look forward to making new memories, I think, because if you're stuck in your old memories, it's a loop. It's nothing. It's just a memory. So I think you should look forward to making new one. You'll be more happier in your life. You'll be happier in your life. Who is your personal hero? I think my grandfather was my. He just passed away this year, so he is my personal hero. He taught me yoga, he taught me maths, we used to watch cricket together. I started doing a lot of work on my vocabulary and English because I started reading editorials of cricket magazines and everything. So that all happened because of him, and all my academic credentials, all because of him. So I owe him half of my life. How would you spend $1 billion? All on myself. No, I would distribute it, first of all, to people who've been spending money on me, like my family. Like, whenever we go out for dinner, I'd never carry my wallet. They've been paying for me since ever I was a child, and that's when they've not even started earning, my sister. They were not even earning, and they used to treat me. So I'll spend all my $1 billion is a lot, but I'll spend $1 million on them, and billion ka 1/10, I think. I'll you know, set up a good house. I think that's my very innermost wish. What's your greatest failure? Oh, I don't have failures in my life. I hate failures. You know, I heard Shah Rukh Khan say that you should hate failures. So I think I also hate failures. And I don't have any failures. I shouldn't count anything as my failure right now. Everything that I thought was a failure worked in my favor. So there's not been a failure. But my I can't overcome failures also. So it's like when I'm a failure, I'm like, I feel okay. Then I cry about it and then I overcome it. So, but that has not happened as of now. So no failures. Let's not talk about failures. What's your greatest achievement and how has it shaped you? My greatest achievement has been to come into this industry, because I can tell you guys that when I was a child, and my sister and everyone will vouch for it, that I used to sit in my room and I didn't do anything. I was very shy of public speaking, very shy of going on stage, very shy of talking to people, very shy of mixing, conversing, everything. And now I've become an actor. So you need to do everything. Yeah. Because, so that has been my greatest achievement. I've become a different person totally after entering this industry. So it's been an achievement to come here on my own and learn things. When is the live chat segment with PJ happening? Oh, it'll happen soon. I'll force him because he's not been around. So I'll ask him if we can do it together, and I'm sure he'll be more than happy to do it. If you could speak or learn another language, which would it be and why? I have no other language skills other than English and Hindi. And Hindi has become adulterated lately. So I don't have any good language skills. All I know is that I want to learn, which I find very fascinating, would be French. Because a lot of people around me claim to know, they know French. They don't know French, but they claim to know. So I also want to learn French. And it sounds very romantic and like poetry. What makes you happiest? Food. Food which makes you, which tastes good and which is healthy. Which is not there in this universe. What's the craziest thing you've ever done? I'm not done. I'm very boring. I've not done crazy things. Craziest thing I've done is, one day I sneaked out of my house at midnight when my parents were not home. And my servant caught me. And I was like, please don't tell them that I sneaked out. That was very crazy, because when I came back to my own house after sneaking out, it was locked from outside. So I was like, how do I enter my own house and who has locked it? That was crazy. If you could have a superpower, which one would it be and why would it be that superpower? I think to be invisible, yeah. That's very common superpower that everyone wants to have. But I want to be invisible and go and eavesdrop on different people, what they're talking about me. Because I don't bitch about people, so I want to know if people are bitching about me. If you could love someone else's life, who would it be? Alia Bhatt. Because she just is becoming a very good actor and... she's doing some very good projects with good actors, and she's becoming more confident in her own skin. Like she knows her strengths and her weaknesses, but she's, I don't know, her and her school of acting really resonates with mine. I like the way she acts. So yeah, also Anushka Sharma maybe, but yeah, I like Alia Bhatt's life at this moment. What was the last book you read, and are you reading one right now? Yes, I'm reading a book right now. It's an autobiography of Nasiruddin Shah, and just finished like 100 odd pages. So that's the book I read. So these are the questions. There were 17 questions, and I've never known so much about myself before this quiz. I think now I know myself better thanks to you, Maria. You ask me such questions that are, you know, mind-boggling. So I really loved playing this quiz. Thank you so much again. Thank you. I'll keep this... And I think I'll ask these questions to people because they're very thought-provoking. You come to know a lot about yourself. Yeah. I never thought about what my greatest failure was to you, which is good.
Okay, so happy birthday again and have a blast. Oh, God
you,
bless
thank you. Thank you.
Whatever you want, you will come across like
me. Yes. I will get everything that I want, and my birthday will make me a superwoman. Yeah, and thank you guys. Thank you for each and every word, everything that you've sent across. It means a lot to me. I can't put it in words, but it means a lot. Thank you.